We definitely have an unfinished business in terms of women economic empowerment, women political empowerment, and elimination of violence against women. Women economic empowerment, the percentage of women entering the labor force has increased from 40% to 49%. We still have a 26% gap between women and men. If we were to address this gap, this could translate to up to 15% economic growth in some developing countries. In terms of women political empowerment, as I've mentioned, we still have a great disparity in terms of men, women parliamentarian. But when we go to the local level, it's even worse, where we're only speaking about a fairly small percentage of women political leaders. And this is a major issue because we know that when we can increase the political representation of women, we tend to see a different type of public investment. And we can tend to see much more resources being allocated to the type of critical social infrastructure and services, such as access to energy, access to water, childcare, that enable to reduce the unpaid work of women and enables them to basically seize new opportunities.